In America, we're YNT. We're hanging out backstage, the Oakland Coliseum. Big day on the Green Show. Scorpions, Rat, YNT, Metallica. It's going to be an incredible show. But right now, I just have this incredible opportunity to introduce you, that's right, America, to our friend and friendly mascot,
Rock.
Rock. So we figure since he's such one of the boys, you know, maybe he can, like, take over some of our interview chores, you know, because, you know, we're on the road getting burnt out. Maybe he can, like, take over. So, Rock, I'm going to get you primed for this, all right? You ready? So I figure, you know, let's see how you handle yourself with the press. Like, if the press comes up and says, what about that new album coming out called Down for the Count in October? What are you going to say?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, we're having. And what about that hot new video coming out? What's that going to be like?
Yeah. Rock, man, I want to tell you. Speaking of videos, man, in the video awards, they don't have a category for robots, and you are the baddest robot in video,
but we got something for Rock.
We do have something for Rock. We have
the Melvin.
The Melvin.
Just for you, Rock.
Yeah.
Our favorite robot in a supporting and leading role in a video.
Now you too can see him on MTV right now.
Stick around for some more heavy metal videos on Heavy Metal Mania.
Yeah!
Cheers. It's been a long time. We sailed with fury across the oceans of the world. Legend lives, it stays forever. We are runners of the world. We are rulers of the ocean. Kings of seven seas.
Lars and James from Metallica here.
And don't go away, there's more metal videos coming up on Heavy Metal Mania. And we're
everybody, my name is Yngwie Malmsteen. I'm now appearing on Metal Mania on MTV, wonderful station that is. I just came off stage in Oakland Coliseum in front of 60,000 people. I had a wonderful time on stage. And what can I say, you know, it's great. You know, middle of the day, a lot of sun, wonderful. And here's some more metal videos with Japanese metal masters, Loudness.
If you like to gamble, I tell you I'm your man. You win some, lose some, it's all the same to me. The pleasure is to blame, ain't no difference what you say. I'm a shade green, the only card I need is the ace of spades. The ace of spades.
heavy rock band victory.
Jawohl.
Platte auf dem Punkt für mehr harten Metallrock hier aus Oakland, aus Amerika.
And we want you to stay tuned to watch MTV's Heavy Metal Mania. Don't go away.
No! I better not.
Just about wraps it up for this special Heavy Metal Mania from the Day on the Green here in Oakland, California.
We had a great time here, and everybody out there did too.
Thanks to all the bands who played with us here today.
We have one more video to play for you, but first,
here it comes. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Is falling down into the night.
16 for the year was from The Outfield and Your Love. Several old bands from earlier decades performed this year, reformed this year, and staged big comebacks, but there were also several major bands from the 80s who either lost members, like Van Halen or Chicago, or dissolved altogether, like Wham. Here's a look at many of the major departures and breakups of 1986.
After selling 20 million records worldwide in just 3 years, Wham called it quits this June in front of 80,000 people, just like they planned it.
We'd always known that there was a definite limit on the group's lifespan. Our goal was very much to do what we've done, and we've done it, and to keep on going would have made it seem very much a business venture.
For the rest of the year, Andrew Ridgely drove racing cars, pursued acting roles, and got engaged, while George Michael found another partner and started work on a much-anticipated solo album. Prince broke up the Revolution in October, seeking a new musical combination for a new stripped-down sound. Wendy Melvoin and Lisa Coleman formed a group of their own, and drummer Bobby Z will produce other artists. His replacement is rumored to be Sheila E. Duran Duran also shrank a bit in 86. The Notorious Ones now number only three, as guitarist Andy Taylor released two solo singles and worked on his album. It was during the sessions for their own album that Simon, Nick, and John saw the split coming.
It was so screamingly obvious that it was not happening. You know, we said, well, you know, there's no point in trying to force this issue because we had nothing in common, either musically or mentally.
The Cars' Ben Orr was one artist who went solo without leaving his band. Ditto bandmate Rick Ocasek, who said his Emotion in Motion could have just as easily been a Cars song.
I don't specifically write songs for the Cars or myself and handpick. Whatever I have at the moment that I have written, you know, I use.
And Daryl Hall released Three Hearts and a Happy Ending Machine while declaring there's no ending for the hit-making machine he's got with John Oates.
John and I have been banging around for years and years, and the only way to keep things going is by trying new things.
After 18 years with Chicago, Peter Cetera broke rank and hit number one twice. The band survived without him, but they haven't yet reached their previous height. And then there was the split that never happened. Yes, the Rolling Stones did release a new album in 86, and they actually got together for a couple of videos and a special Grammy Award in London. But a much-talked-about tour remained just that. Much-talked-about.
You planning to tour?
I hope so. Let's put it like that. I really can't give a definitive answer to that, but I'm working on it.
Yeah, I think we must go out and tour.
No, we don't have any tour plans at the moment.
Most of us do. It's just a matter of convincing the others, or the other, whether they want to tour or not.
Each Stone rolled alone in 86. Keith Richards produced Aretha Franklin, negotiated a solo album deal, and performed at Chuck Berry's 60th birthday party.
Go, Keith, go, go, go!
Charlie Watts took a big band on tour around the states. Bill Wyman and Ron Wood played with Rod Stewart and the Faces and made tour with them next year. As for Mick Jagger, the Stones' last video may well sum up his feelings. So, he started work on solo album number two.
Well, there's no news yet on a possible Stones breakup or reunion, but there's sure to be more speculation in 87. As we just saw, one of the other big music news stories of the year was the departure of Andy Taylor from Duran Duran. His first video as a solo artist was the 15th biggest video of 1986. This is Take It Easy.
We'll be right back.
rubbish you can see. A quarter something special coming up to MTV. We brighten up your picture and we send you on your way. So don't forget to turn to us, MTV today.
When I graduated high school, I wanted a quality college education, but I didn't want to leave home. I found I didn't have to. I found Dominican College.
Dominican offers the courses towards a four-year degree you would expect from larger colleges with all the advantages of a small school. It's personalized education, stressing academic excellence in a scenic environment.
Discover a world of knowledge close to home. Discover Dominican College.
Hi, Jeff.
Call for spring course schedule. Registration is January 22nd.
Hey, Billy, what college basketball team has had 30 wins a season or more for the last five consecutive seasons?
Indiana.
Wrong! What team has won its conference the last five consecutive years?
UCLA.
Wrong! Rogan, it's St. Thomas Aquinas College.
I've heard of those guys, the Spartans.
Yeah, and you're going to see them too on TKR's Channel 30.
Great!
I have a question for you, Frank. How are you going to stop this?
TKR Game of the Week on Channel 30.
I need it now, before it gets too risky. When the weather gets bad, I mean really bad, that's when I need the Weather Channel's severe weather coverage. They don't just tell me what's happening, they tell me why, and most important, what to do. When I need it now, I turn to the Weather Channel. Later just might be too late.
When severe weather threatens, that's when you need the Weather Channel most.
On TKR, Look at All We Are, Tuesday. Comedy's playing the field. On WTBS, you've got a full count for laughs, safe at home. And on HBO, you're catching all the fun. Football Follies, 1st and 10. Safe at home at 6:35, 1st and 10 at 10 o'clock. Comedy's playing the field for a Tuesday.
Watch them. And if I'm lying, I'm buying. Free cable for a year. If you spot Showtime's exclusives on HBO or Cinemax. Plus this trophy. Plaque reads to Armando, but you can change that, I think.
The MTV Top 100 Countdown. A recap of the best year in video music. Watch for it all weekend long. Dude.
We're MTV.
We are counting down the top 100 videos of 1986, and shortly after we're done, you can catch a world premiere from Huey Lewis and the News. It's a live performance of the song Jacob's Ladder. You can see it tonight at 10:30 p.m. Eastern and 7:30 Pacific. Continuing with our countdown of the top 100 videos, the video at number 14 is the biggest this year by an actor from Canada. Here's Loverboy and This Could Be the Night.
Ask any girl in this lonely world. Ask any girl, she'll say, make it last forever. I'm holding out my hand. I finally understand. So turn out the lights. Oh yeah, we'll make it last forever. Sometimes I was so on a spot. You found what was love.